Hello, this is Dr. Dheeraj Masapu. I'm a consultant anesthesiologist and specialized in neuroanesthesiology. And many of you have requested a video on freelancing as a career after MD anesthesia or DNB anesthesiology. And for that, I have invited a guest speaker who has done his MD anesthesia from SMS Jaipur 10 years ago. And he is Dr. Mithun, and he has significant experience as a freelancer, and he is one of the successful freelancers in Bangalore. So what we are going to ask him is, so after MD anesthesia, how to start freelance practice, and what are the pros and cons associated with the freelance practice? So these are the two questions that we are going to ask him. So welcome to the channel, Dr. Mithun.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Mithun.
So, hi Mithun. So, my first question would be, after passing MD anesthesia, if somebody wants to start freelance, so if you tell your journey, how you started and how actually you entered into freelancing, so that itself is enough, I think.
Okay. First of all, I did my undergraduate from 2002 to 2007. Afterwards, so I took 1 year to get a seat. From 2009 to 2012, I did my MD anesthesia from SMS Jaipur. After that, I joined a medical college in Bangalore. I was there almost for 5 years, but I was not satisfied. According to financially, I was getting a meager amount from the medical college. I wanted extra money. So I decided starting freelancing along with the medical college profession. But it was very difficult because people outside the market expected 24/7. If you are in a medical college, you'll be stuck up in 9 to 4. 9 to 4 means from 8 onwards up to 5 o'clock, you'll be stuck up because you have to punch in, punch out everything. So people, I approached so many hospitals in and around my area. They are like, I'm available before 8, I'm available after 5. Everybody rejected me. And nobody knows me also before that because I was new to Bangalore. Finally, I made my mind to quit medical college because of some. I wanted freedom. Basically, I wanted freedom. For even if you want to, like holidays or.
So basically, time or restriction you didn't want it.
Yeah, time restriction. If you want to go out, like for example, if my family expects take a leave for 4 days, I was not getting that. Because our seniors, my HODs, everyone, like it was difficult for them to give attestation for 4 days, 5 days leave frequently or whenever you want like that.
Got it. So that is one of your prerequisites in life.
And I wanted freedom, like I want to be my own boss. If you want to accept the case, I accept. Otherwise, just say I'm out of station. That is the easiest way to reject the case. I'm out of station.
Got it. So how did you start the freelancing? Because after your MD anesthesia, if somebody approaches a hospital, most of the time it's not possible.
Not possible. Seriously, it is near to impossible only. Yeah. Because All India, through All India, I went to like SMS Medical Jaipur. So much of experience. I approached so many hospitals outside. And I gave my card, everything. Nobody accepted me. Nobody, not even a single small case they gave me. Because everybody is scared of anesthesia. If something happens, the hospital will be ransacked by the people. So much and fear for the patient and also hospital management also. And especially for surgeons also, because they lose their career if the patient goes wrong outside.
So they don't call new people?
Like they won't call new people. They won't call new people. They want at least, they want to know the anesthesia beforehand only. Especially pediatric anesthesia, even the patients are very much scared.
Yes.
They'll say, I want to meet anesthesiologist first.
Got it.
Beforehand only.
I'm feeling actually happy because so much of value anesthesia is getting.
Yeah,
so
seriously. Around 60% they won't know, but almost 40% the awareness has come up.
Okay.
In the market.
Got it. So still 40.
It will take almost 4 years to grow you if you want to get a name, like you want to be a full-time freelancer.
You took
at least take 3-4 years.
So and since 10 years you've been doing this.
Yeah, 2016-17 I'm doing.
So then what are the pros and cons?
That is very much needed. that's independent also. The pros are freedom.
Okay.
So time freedom.
Okay.
Whenever you want, you can accept the case.
Okay.
Whenever like I'm not in the mood, you can reject, like I'm out of station. And nobody bothers you.
Got it.
Second is financially also.
Yeah.
It's case basis.
Yeah.
If you're in a medical college, it's a fixed salary and fixed what do you call increment also. Here as the like inflation, it also goes up.
Got it. I understood.
And again, if the patient admits in suit, if your patient admits in deluxe,
okay.
If your patient admits in general ward, again our remuneration proportionately increases.
Okay. It is
if the patient stays in general ward, if the patient stays in suit,
okay.
The difference they get.
Yes. Got it. So VIP patient payment will be different. Okay, understood. Super. So freedom and money, both are there. So these are the pros and cons.
Disadvantage is,
yeah,
it's very, very stressful life. Very, very stressful life. They call in the midnights and you'll be totally independent in the midnight.
Got it.
Only surgeon, one or two nursing staff and no OT technician will be there.
Got it.
In corporate hospital, so many DNB students,
yeah,
OT technicians, everyone will be there.
Yeah, but three anesthesiologists will be there at any point. Yeah.
There in the midnight, you'll be all alone. And one surgeon, he'll be busy in his job,
yeah.
One nurse and one floor nurse. If that also very difficult, you have to manage, you should be very confident and you should also play safely.
So then a lot of tension moments will be there.
And the patient will come like full stomach and no investigations, no 2D echoes.
Got it.
Don't know his heart status,
yeah.
Don't know his other physical conditions.
Yes, emergency. It is not possible.
Not possible.
Yeah.
And sometimes patient will not be affordable. You can't get 2D echo for everyone.
Yes.
And that will be a very difficult period for us.
So then for that, your skill should be in the next level.
Yeah. You should be confident enough. Otherwise, the surgeon will not call you.
Got it.
For example, if you put spinal 3-4 times, if you keep on pricking, next time you will not get a call.
Got it.
And from that hospital, you will not get a call.
So, your skills.
If the patient is not comfortable with you,
okay.
The patient will complain to the hospital or surgeon, then gone. So will not be called.
Actually, before talking to you, I was actually thinking that you don't have to communicate in freelancing.
No. It's a must. You have to talk to the patient, you have to talk to the attenders. It's a good practice before and only I go. Like, even if it's a midnight, fresh call also, I make it in mind, talk to the patient attenders, everyone beforehand, and interop,
nobody talks,
like post-op and regarding post-op analgesia, if it's epidural pump and all.
Almost like what we are doing, you're doing actually.
Yeah.
I was actually in the myth that, only in corporates, the communication is good. In freelancing, people don't talk directly, they'll go and they'll give, I was thinking.
That depends on individual. I make it practice, I talk to the patient, attenders, pre-op and post-op.
Okay, got it.
And I instruct them post-op also, what and all to do, not to do.
So basically, and second thing is, most of the regionals is what you guys do.
Yeah, we go actually, if you can see myself, I'm a regional fellow.
Okay.
For all cases, if it's a lap coli, spinal. Lap appendix, spinal. Lap hysterectomy, spinal.
Got it.
Lap hernia, spinal.
Got it.
Everything spinal. For orthopedics also, upper limb, regional blocks.
Brachial blocks,
interscalene blocks, supraclavicular blocks.
So doing regional anesthesia fellowship, if somebody does, I think
it will be advantages.
Advantages.
Because for all outside practices, you want to be safe and minimal anesthesia you want to give.
Got it.
Don't go for general anesthesia, then again, difficult intubation, full stomach, that all comes into the picture. If you know the regional anesthesia pakka, it will be very easy for you.
Our practice is opposite to that. We go for more general anesthesias. Okay, so regional anesthesia, guys, regional anesthesia fellowship he is recommending because that will actually help you in doing the case faster and recovery will be faster. And also post-operative pain, you don't have to think much. Maybe when you have to go to another center for another case, so regional will take care of the pain.
Yeah.
That's what you're trying to tell, no?
Yeah. Now so many adjuvants have come.
Yeah.
Clonidine, buprenorphine, Dexmedetomidine is very wonderful post anesthesia.
Superb. So we discussed about the pros and cons and second thing, the requirement of equipments, because every hospital, see, I'm used to an OT.
Yes.
So I have 3-4 OTs and I'm used to that. See, for you it is not like that. Every
yes.
hospital is
different.
Every OT.
Yes.
How do you deal with that?
First of all, you should check the machine properly.
Okay.
Properly drugs, emergency yes. crash cart,
okay.
oxygen,
okay.
suction machine, very important.
Okay.
You'll be screwed up if you don't have suction machine.
Got it.
Because suction machine, if you don't get
most
it,
important.
The patient will use
yeah, yeah.
full stop
aspiration. Yeah, yeah.
Will be screwed 100%. Up. So suction machine, emergency drugs, laryngoscopes, airways,
yes.
ET tubes, different types of airways.
Yes. Eye gels.
Bougie.
Got it.
And machine and the jumbo cylinder oxygen.
So 10-15 minutes you have to first check everything. And
yes,
then,
yes. Yes, definitely. Don't jump into giving anesthesia.
Okay. How is your training in SMS helping you? Because SMS is one of the top centers
yes.
in India.
Yes. I had a very huge experience there. Lot of yes, like it has got 100 OT tables.
100 tables is
yes.
like unimaginable. I think it will be highest in India.
No, BGMC Ahmedabad.
It is even more.
I think maybe around 80-90 PGs per year anesthesia.
Okay.
So it is a 24. 240 people will be there in the gallery for seminars.
Whoa, like MBBS batch.
Yes, MBBS.
So then, so during the PG time only, you must be doing alone.
Yeah, alone.
Like first year onwards, you'll be doing
all specialties. Like from pediatric to geriatric.
So then, neuro also you must.
Neuro, cardiac, pediatric, everything.
Everything like independent.
Independent.
So that is.
In the second year itself, second year of my PG only, I was doing beating CABG all alone.
Okay. So that is the
beginning. So all high end and high risk cases we have tackled. So no need to worry in the outside in freelancing.
Many of your juniors also would be watching this video from SMS.
Yeah.
I think it will be very inspiring for them
yes,
to see you as a senior from SMS.
Yes.
Maybe 10 years senior, but still,
yes,
you know,
definitely.
To see you in this position, one of the successful freelancers in Bangalore. So, any advice you want to tell juniors in anesthesia post MD who want to come into freelancing?
Yes. First of all, you should have strong theoretical knowledge and practical knowledge and you should be very much confident, you should not be scared, you should not be panicked. And before and only check everything, oxygen, airways, drugs, and the surgeon confidence also. And all of a sudden if you get the calls, you should check the pre-op investigations, 2D echo, at least ECG. Don't go jump into giving spinal when the patient has a 2D ejection fraction of 30-40, you'll be screwed up.
Got it. Basically, strong theoretical knowledge and the clinical skills.
Yes.
And communication also is
communication.
Good.
So always talk to the patient before and only. That way you will be safe.
Safe, correct. Got it. So, what kind of support you get from the societies or if you are stuck in a problem, for example, let us assume you are stuck in a problem.
Yeah, we have got a private practitioners anesthesia forum also.
Yeah,
in a WhatsApp group we have.
Okay.
If I don't know like how to give about in this a difficult case, like if the patient is on anticoagulants.
Okay.
Like what is the
latest guidelines
and all. If you're forgotten or you're confused, you can talk to the other anesthesia colleagues.
Got it.
And so if you're a difficult case, you can talk to them and you can decide the
got
plan.
It. So you have some support system.
The forum is there.
But still, by default, it is riskier than corporate practice.
Yes, definitely.
No doubt.
Because you'll be all alone.
You'll be alone. Yes,
and,
yes. So that
all alone doing is riskier also. But
yeah.
If you're confident, it will go.
Yes. So, but post MD immediately. Post MD immediately. Do you suggest somebody entering or 3-4 years of waiting period is required? What do you think?
Better if you work in a corporate. Basically,
senior.
What happens is ultimately money is not everything.
Mm-hmm.
You should know the knowledge how the corporate people works, how the medical college works,
mm-hmm.
how the freelancing works. You can merge medical college and freelancing,
okay.
or you can merge corporate and freelancing.
Okay.
And you'll be like, yes, I've experienced this
okay,
in my part of life.
Yeah.
So I'm leaving this part, I'm going to freelancing. Like that.
So, but some 3-4 years of
experience is better.
To be on safe side. So to become like you, full-time freelancer, I think 6-7 years it will take.
It will take.
So, I think thank you, Dr. Mithun. You know, this video, actually it's very tough to, you know, talk to a freelancer. And that's it, guys. Hope I think you got a lot of information about freelancing. Many people are asking about freelancing. I know you also want to know about the financial part. I am discussing that with him. It will be told in a separate video, not in this video. Subscribe to the channel. Okay, thank you.